Hey folks, this is Best in Slow. Welcome back to our Jurassic World Evolution 2 RNG decided park build. The park build where we let the Wheel of Doom determine how our park build is going to go. What dinosaurs are we going to have? What kind of biome? What kind of decorations? All that kind of jazz. I know it's been a little bit wild. Things were a little bit crazy over Christmas and New Year's, but I'm committed to working on this build and we're going to do just that today. Just realized I was on the wrong page. So, Wheel of Doom, be good to me. No. That's what the Wheel of Doom sounds like, in case you were curious. Last time around, we had three species. Let's check it out. How many are we going to get in exhibit number two? It's two! Fantastic. Count plus one. Lovely stuff. A good number, a good solid number. We can definitely work with that. I'm just glad it's not a one or a four, quite frankly. Let's find out what those two species are going to be. Okay, so two spins of the wheel this time. Let's see what we end up with. It's Brachio. Oh, very nice. Okay, that's an exciting one. You know, loads of big verticality, a big chunky dinosaur to really round out the habitat. Now, hopefully we don't get another sauropod. Hopefully we get something quite a lot smaller, and then we've got a really nice contrast going on there. Here we go. Brachiosaurus and... Oh, no. Wheel of Doom, why? Wheel of Doom. Why have you done this to me? Wheel of Doom, no! I promise this wasn't rigged in any way whatsoever. 89 inputs, and on the second bloody video, it gives me the Myosaurus. It is a good contrast with the Brachiosaurus, but... Oh boy, right, okay. Okay, third step, what era are we going to build in? What fences are we going to use? What decorations? All that kind of jazz. Here we go. Last time it was Jurassic World. Time it's Malta. Okay, that's gonna be a interesting one. We might have to build in a different direction for that one because it's gonna clash quite a lot with Jurassic World, but maybe that's kind of the challenge. Maybe we'll find a way to make that work. Finally then, we're gonna pick two biomes for our Brachiosaurus and our Myosaurus to share. Last time it was grasslands and beach. This time just ticked over to forest. Nice, a good one there. Let's find out. It's a forest breaching onto what? What sits with our forest? It's gonna be a cow. Oh god. Okay. Oh no, I forgot to change the text. Sorry. Okay, well, I'm really glad that we didn't get any duplicates there. We got new options in every single one. A forest canyon is going to be a tricky build. I've got a fun idea in my head. Whether that works or not is a whole other kettle of fish. Okay then folks, welcome back to the park. I've made a couple of small changes since last time around. I've changed the colour of the path. I find that this facility path and this squishy quilty, it looks really soft. It looks like it would be like a like you could bounce on it a little bit. We've all been there. This one and this one, I find they go a little bit better together than the red one I was using. Obviously filled in this area over here, made some changes over here as well. The fence, you'll have seen I moved it in the last video, you know, doing this, putting it into place, doesn't really work. It kept jumping around, kept bouncing off into space basically, so I deleted that and I've replaced that with this one, which means it does get a little finicky over there at the far end, but I think it's okay. Anyway, it's just a little detail in the area to make it look a little bit more like a park. It's surprisingly busy. Anyways, we have a Maltese-themed Brachiosaurus and Myosaurus habitat to work on, which is a forest canyon, and I've had what I think is a really fun idea for this build. So what we're going to do, I think this is probably a good spot for us as well. I had this image pop into my head of a forest that breaks, you know, it's a dense forest for the Brachiosaurus and the Myosaurus to wander around in, and then the forest breaks, and then just beyond the break of the forest, there's like a sheer cliff edge, basically. So it's like this forest that overlooks the canyon below. So they're not going to go in the canyon, they're going to go atop the canyon, but I think it's going to make for like a really dramatic looking habitat. So we have to make it. So I'm thinking we're probably going to have to kill this river, now that I think about it. Maybe I'll have it... Oh, it's too far away. Right. Let me get some height first. How tall... The first step is, how big do we want this to be? Because it has to feel like, you know, I need to look at it. Yeah, I see already that I think that's good. Am I making any sense? Right, so basically, if you imagine the forest comes up to like here, and then the rest of it, they can go to like the very edge and they can look over there, and we'll get this really like dramatic shot of the volcano in the background and these brachies standing perched at the tip of this canyon. So the challenge, of course, is making this go down to here in like one smooth ramp. That's really the main challenge, actually, for this habitat, more than anything else. I think we're going to have to kill the river, because I don't think we're going to have space otherwise. Sorry, river. No! That's what rivers sound like when you murder them, by the way. Be nice to the environment, okay? Otherwise, they'll scream. Now, why are you making squares? That's very odd. Please stop. Actually, you know, is that a bad thing? I don't know. And using our terrain tools, we can max out the slope. And really, this is the kind of thing you can't really do. You can do this without mods, of course. But because terrain tools let me make really steep slopes like that, you know, we can get a much more dramatic effect. So it's going to be a nice gentle ramp. So they're going to be able to sort of wander around the whole thing. But I think that's quite a lot of room already. Tell you what, tell you blim blamming what. Let's just have a little look here. Yeah, it's already... Yeah, so that's what I mean. That's going to look really cool. Very dramatic, anyway. Okay, I've changed my mind a little bit. I think what we're going to do is we're going to run a monorail. Monorail. We're going to run a monorail. A monorail. Bloody no. We're going to run a monorail track up the hill. Because I was just looking at the ramp and thinking, no one's going to walk up there. No one's ever going to be willing to climb those steps. We might put one next to it as well. We'll see. But I think a monorail is going to look a little bit more effective. Let me just... shuffle that into place like so, and then we'd have one that plus it gives a nice bit of height, which I always appreciate. And let's grab another one, and you know what, we can have this as a stop up here at the very top, you know, observe. The idea is so they can observe the brachies, of course, as they're standing over the cliff. But we can also then carry this on elsewhere and, you know, maybe make that look pretty cool like that. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to sink this. I want this to feel more like a, less like a monorail and more like a train line, I suppose. So if we grab our monorail and we sink that into the ground like so, we'll have to kind of make an entrance for it. But if we do that and then we connect the track, which I probably should have done first. Really work, does it? Just making some small notches in there. I want it to feel like a very straight edge at the top. I want it to feel, you know, like a big, like spooky sort of cliff edge, but I don't want it to feel like it's been carved by humans. You know, you want it to have sort of like ridges and little bits in it like that. I'm still trying to decide how they're going to get up the hill. I'm kind of going back and forth between whether I want it to be a monorail or a path. What if we do both? So if we do the path Going up like so. So, then I want a viewing. Oh, we're using Malta, aren't we? I kind of forgot about the Malta. So let's get the Malta into play. A couple of viewing galleries. Like so. They're the ones. We'll have some more sort of along the way as well. But these are here to sit at the top and do their thing. Try to get that like nice and straight like so. Okay, let's get this exhibit wall built and we'll go from there. So what we need is a pretty strong looking fence, I'm going to suggest. Nothing crazy, but something that, you know, you feel... The problem with the cable, I really like the idea of using the cable fence, but the problem is a Brachiosaurus is just going to... This is going to walk over it, you know? It doesn't really work. We're going to use an invisible one for this section here. Well, there's going to be a fence there, and then the invisible wall is going to go like this. So this is really here just to, again, kind of like with the last habitat, just control where the dinosaurs go. I want them to go right to the edge of the cliff, but I don't want them to go off the edge of the cliff for fairly obvious reasons, I think. I kind of want them to avoid these little dinks and stuff that we put in as well. Yeah, dink. Okay, after quite a lot of time of trying to make this bloody gallery work, I think I realised that, well, the gallery's not going to work. So what we're going to do is change it up very slightly. We're going to put in a small log wall. When I can find it, there it is. And it's just going to be a little seated rest slash viewing area that sits in a little semicircle, hopefully. Need to be able to make a semicircle first, but once I can make a semicircle, it's going to sit in a little semicircle at this point here. So, well, let's make that bigger than we need to start off, and then we'll work backwards. That's a plan. I messed up my... No, we're okay. So I just want to make this a perfectly smooth semicircle from there. Oh. There we go. That'll do. Doesn't need to be huge, really. Yeah. I'm not making any jokes. So we've got that there, and then we flatten again, nice and high, stats like so, and we just bring this to the edge of the fence, as close as we can get it, without causing any problems. Yeah, okay, that made a lot more sense. Tell you what, and because I do want... there's no viewing tower for Malta. Okay, so the challenge here now, I really like this bit. I think this bit looks really good. I've got the water in here as well to kind of force the dinosaurs out to this ledge. I just think when we get like this kind of view, I might even pull the forest out just a little bit more. I think that's going to look really, really cool. The challenge now, though, is how much forest do I do everywhere else? This has to be really dense. Now, this viewing gallery is essentially pointless, yes. But the idea of them just emerging out of the forest like that to stand over the top of the cliff, I think it's very, very exciting. The challenge more is, what do I do with this bit? This bit has a problem in that it's shrouded in shadow. It's kind of not catching the light, and that makes it look a little bit dull. It looks a lot better like this in capture mode. This is what I want it to look like all the time, but unfortunately it cannot. So how do we make this bit more interesting in here? I think we need to... I think it's fine to have lots of forest here, but maybe we need to give a reason for our dinosaurs to hang out in this sort of lower flat region around here, near where this viewing area is going to be. Well, already is, I suppose. I don't want to put the water there, but maybe we can have that food source there. Let's grab some Myasaur. Hello, you. Whoa, what's going on here? Why is there a billion cosmetics there? Oh, maybe you're not the worst thing in the world, Myasaur. It's just something, like, it's not like it's particularly inaccurate or anything. There's just something about its stupid bloody head shape. Right, it needs ground fiber and ground nuts. So let's get that in. It does have water, but it's not going to realize that until it gets up there because it's a big old dummy. Let's do this. So this is going to be the feeding grounds / nesting grounds. That's what we'll do to make this a bit more interesting. Hopefully this will work for the brachies as well. I don't know what the brachies need, per se. And now, thanks to one of those lovely mods, what we can do is throw in some really cool decorations. So let's get a log. Everyone needs a log. And then what I want to use is... I was thinking about this viewing frame as well, but I don't think this is the time. I think we need like a small dinosaur. If we end up with a small one, we'll pop that in. We've got this lovely Mesozoic... got a big Mayan head. But no, what I'm looking for is... the nests and stuff like that. Yeah, these things. I want this to be like a nesting area. Get some droppings in there. So we're going to have a big nest. That's for the brachies. Some big eggs in there. And then we'll have some smaller ones for the Myasaur. Decided they have clutches of 3 to 4. Now, of course, a couple of hatched ones in the area. There may not be baby dinosaurs in this game, but we can bloody well pretend that there are. Some dinosaur droppings. Smatter them out a little bit like so. Okay. Yeah, cool. Oh, Myasaur, you're growing on me. No, I can't. I can't. I can't betray who I am as a person, as a man, for this Myasaur nonsense. The lights are going to stay. I always think it's helpful to have... well, obviously, this area is meant to be Maltese-themed. But having some constants, like using the same lamppost all the time, just gives your park a little bit of... just makes it seem more logical. I don't know. This bit I dislike, but I think it's okay. At least they're using the monorail. The idea is they use the monorail. They're not actually meant to walk up here. I wonder if I can block them somehow. Okay. Let's get these brachies in. And then I need to stretch my fingers a little bit, because bloody Nora, tensing up the intensity of Jurassic World Evolution 2. Hello, beautiful. That's oh, look at them emerging. That's exactly what I wanted. They emerge from the forest to drink over the cliffside. So, Brachiosaurus. I definitely want. Oh, I like you. But obviously, we've got our new Frontier Skin Jurassic Park 3 Brachies. So I think that might be what we use. I really like this one. This white and orange JP3 one. You can see it's got that sharper crest, like the tick at the back of the crest is sharper. This is larger and sort of thicker and skinnier at the same time. It's hard to describe. And then we need another color for this one. That I really like. Different pattern maybe though. Yeah, sweet. That's a good combo. Now you have to go into here. I can't have you there already. Now, what do you need food-wise? Okay, you've got some tall nut, which is what you need. Like, as long as they've got a little bit of the food they require, I'm pretty happy. Like, because it means they won't die. I can keep food requirements on. You can use it to move them around the habitat, which is, you know, important as well. So I'm going to say that aspect is done. Now, the aspect that obviously isn't done is the decoration. And the decoration is going to be a pain because I can't really decorate on the slope because decorations will kill the slope. Decorations hate slopes, right? Generally speaking. I think the only thing we can do really, like if I put like a planter along here, it's just going to kill it. It's just going to flatten the area out. I think if I use modded decorations, that isn't the case. But I don't think there's any modern decorations that would feel particularly appropriate. Big tree! My beloved! What if we use, like... I'm not going to put this in, but what if we use something... I don't hate the idea of having, like, some... Because these look like they could fit with the Maltese sort of style, right? So... I hate the idea of having some of those in there. Let's get some Maltese buildings. God, that Brachiosaurus noise makes me so happy. It's ridiculous. It's such a beautiful sound. Oh, the Maltese stuff is quite hard to work with. It's so different to everything else, you know? And you see what I mean, where it's flattening it. So I can't really... I can put a little bit more in, maybe? And that's probably about my limit without things breaking. Okay, I've done a little bit of decoration work. Really just tried my hardest to integrate the Malta stuff. It's okay. It's hard to... The Malta stuff is very, very specific in style, and I find it's quite difficult, especially with this big old ramp and stuff like that, to kind of integrate it in a natural sort of way. But I think I've done an okay job. There's bits there, there's bits there. There's not much I can do with this ramp up. I've thrown some flags in and some trees on the right-hand side, and that's about it. And then down here, like it's an entrance to the Maltese section, I suppose. Also the... This is the problem with sinking the monorail into the ground. These people are sitting on the chairs outside the monorail station. And now it looks like they're just sitting on the, they're just sitting on the path having a lovely time. I think I'm pretty happy with the amount of Maltese stuff, and I think it'll look better when there's more stuff here. I'm not really sure if there's anything else I can do with this right-hand side and this sort of path upwards. I need to smooth that out a little bit, but I'm pretty happy with the little area here. I think having the tower in the middle of the fountain looks pretty cool. And we've got some little feeding areas. And then up here, you've got a little pack of Myasora, and then, of course, the Brachy as well. And actually, what I might do is just throw in one more wall. If I can put that about a little bit to the right. And I might just put this into... I was going to put a path there as well, but I don't know if it's going to work. I just kind of want this little area to... Tell you what. Let's get rid of that. If I grab this and have that kind of go like... Yeah. Come on. What if I go from here instead? This will work. It just hates me. Aha! Beautiful. And just having more of the path sort of variation, it just kind of retains that theme we've got going through the park already. So I'm pretty happy with it. I like this little top bit. I think this looks pretty nice. Maybe we need some seating areas or something. I think obviously it's got like a really... So let's hop in the first person. Can we see over the edge? Yeah, sort of. Not quite, but nearly. It's got a really cool view over there. And... I'm happy with the build in general. I just wish it wasn't Malta, to be honest. Malta is now banned for like several episodes, okay? That's the rule. That's the deal. Well, that right there was basically precisely what I wanted. That is, when I started to build this, that is the exact image I had in my head. I wish it was even closer to the edge, but yeah, that's pretty sweet. That's very much what I had in mind. I think that looks really cool. I really do like that. I don't like the exhibit from above for miles away, in terms of how it fits in the park, but I think that view right there is 100% worth it. Them emerging from the tree line to drink, overlooking the canyon, especially with the monorail kind of swooping down and matching the curve of the hill in the background as well. I think I've clipped on a fence a little bit there. I mean, that's pretty sweet, right? Okay, so I'm going to say the build is done. I might, you know, like over here, I might end up doing a little bit of decoration work. I'll probably tidy this area up very slightly as well. That needs a fence or something like that. And then maybe you'll figure out some ways to integrate some more Malta stuff. I don't love the path up there. I do like the little viewing area here, though. I think that's okay. I think it does look better with the capture mode on as well, because it just adds a bit of light into this area here, or a little Mesozoic life area down here. This looks pretty good as well, I think. This exhibit's made me like Myasora. Disastrous. Okay, so we will end it there. Let me know what you think in the comment section down below. I'm going to keep doing slightly crazy things. Last video didn't do particularly well, which is fair enough. It was just kind of a fairly regular old build, really. So I'd like to make sure we're pushing some fun ideas every time. It's not necessarily always going to be crazy, but at least something like a hook. You know, every episode needs a hook beyond the initial premise, and that's more what I'm thinking of. But we'll see how things go. Either way, I really hope you enjoyed today's video. Please let me know what you think in the comment section down below. Throw me a like if you enjoyed it. Yada, 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 yada. Thank you so much for joining me. Cheers much of as always. Bye-bye. Oh.